Hi, Rewiring America. My name is Gaurab Basu. I'm a primary care doctor, and I'm going to show you my electrified home in Massachusetts.
And hey, doctor, I was just walking through the neighborhood.
You were just around.
Yeah, I was just walking through the neighborhood.
Welcome in. Let me show you my favorite. This is our heat pump.
Oh, it's a beauty.
So as like primary care doctor, especially when we had kids, like we just realized like there's this invisible stuff in your home that is not healthy.
This is a mini split, right?
It's a mini split, yep.
Yeah. So there's ducted, there's mini splits, there's some that can just go in a windowsill for an apartment without having to do much of anything.
Next up, induction stove.
Ooh, exciting.
I really think that in the future, we're gonna wonder how the heck we allowed volatile combustible gas, like funneled in from a pipe out there, right into our home.
I mean, it's basically gonna be like in the 70s, inviting your friends over and then just smoking in your living room.
Like as a doctor, like I don't wanna wait for people to get sick and come to me. Like we've gotta proactively put health in people's homes. And build health, you know, into our infrastructure. So this was the first thing we did after we moved into our house. We had to redo our roof.
Yeah.
And then we said we got to put solar panels in right away. All right, Leah.
There's a lot going on right here.
This is the climate corner. This is our heat pump. Then we've got our little EV charger.
And then with this bad baby right here.
This is our newest thing as we got an EV recently.
I mean, the thing is, if you're charging an EV, it's like $1-$2 a gallon. When you compare that to the pump, you know, $4-$5 a gallon, it's way cheaper. And when you've got solar coming into your house, the costs fall even more because that solar panel, you know, it starts to almost make free energy.
All right, Leah, down to the basement, which is the play zone and also the climate solution zone.
Yes, are your electric...
My electric clothes dryer.
Yeah.
Yep. So we don't have any, you know, no gas going into washer dryer. Do you always fumble over this word? It's a long word. A heat pump water heater.
And I can't say I
heat
fumble
pump
over.
Water heater.
And sometimes when you write reports, it's called an HPWH. That's what we call them.
I mean, you know, the solar panels are fun, the heat pumps are fun, the induction stove, like they feel really good, but we should not underestimate like the workhorse is this insulation.
And it actually kind of is the complement to all the other machines because this will make the heat pump work better, right?
Yep.
This will help you save even more money on your energy bills.
You know, it's like all these things work together. You just chip away. Sometimes people can do it all together. Sometimes it takes a while, but I don't know. It just felt good to just get started. They're better. They're normal. They work well. There's like less upkeep. Like they're great.
Yeah.